Okay, welcome everyone. Welcome to the video. And we're going to do something here that we haven't done before, which is to go even further, if that's possible. Well, it is possible, actually. This morning I did it. I've been absorbing it during the daytime. I've had to sleep and rest quite a bit. This is really very difficult to speak the truth in this world. There's such a taboo against it that it's quite shocking and difficult, but we are doing it. This is my job. This is what I do. There will be many refugees. Keep in mind, we're all refugees. We're seeking refuge from the universe, actually. Where do we go to seek refuge from the universe? Well, there is a place we can go. There is a way. And sooner or later, we realize that we are refugees. We're all refugees. We're all desperately seeking a haven, a refuge. And there is a way to practice this, because the refuge is the last place that we would ever think of looking for it. You know, this is so. Where is success? Where is success? Well, keep in mind, success in what? Success in what? Seeking refuge, finding refuge. Where is refuge in this? How can we take refuge from the universe, this awful death machine we call the universe, where everything is manufactured only to die? And it's just a dream of death. Where do we go? Where do we go? So, we are going to look at that. We have some water, which is what I'm advising for refugees. When you come to consider the truth, don't bring food or drink, but just, if you need some water, just bring a little bit of water. Just bring some water. We're getting ready for a refugee situation in this world, an extreme, okay. People would want to take refuge. I say take refuge in practice, right? Practice, yes, yes. Take refuge in the I Am Presence, yes. Well, but how do we practice? Why do we practice? Well, we can say our basic creed is, I am not a body, I am free, for I am exactly as God created me. And there's a slight... You can say, I am not a body, I am free, I am exactly as God created me to be. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created spirit to be. Or, I am not a body, I am free, I am spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, this is the just a basic, fallback. When you make efforts and your mind is saying, okay, I'm tired, what do I anything to fall back on? This is it. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. It's like breathing. Okay. This is our basic breath. This is our basic focus. This is the root. This is our very root assertion, the root assertion. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. So welcome, all refugees. We are all refugees. This is your status. Start seeing yourself as a refugee. Okay, this is important. This humbles yourself. It humbles you, puts you in the right state of mind. I say, be humble in your mind, be severely modest, feel this lowly, like I'm just in this very appreciative refugee status. I'm just looking for a sanctuary. I'm just looking for a sanctuary. I'm not all argumentative or boastful or like I'm large and in charge or something. No, I am looking for a sanctuary from the universe. Is there any possible place? Well, there is. Okay. And so, in our root assertion is that I am not a body. I am free. I am spirit exactly as God created me. I am spirit exactly as God created me. Take it very serious that you are a refugee. You're a refugee. And you really need to accept refugee status. Refugee status. Sooner or later, we'll all recognize this, that indeed we are desperately searching for some refuge from this god-awful universe. It's really a universe designed to prove to ourselves, to arrogance, we're in a state of arrogance, spiritual pride right now. We're having this idea of we're greater than God. So we want to prove to this arrogance that it's not arrogant, it's true. See, it's not arrogant, it's true. So we have this god-awful universe, a dream of death, presenting this to arrogance and saying, hey, look, arrogance, you're not arrogant and saying you can change reality. Look at this. You see, look at how powerful you are. You can create a new kingdom, and we'll just call this reality. You can call it reality. You see, and so you're not arrogant. You're right. So we're trying to prove that arrogance is right. It's not arrogant. Trying to prove that arrogance isn't arrogant. It's a hideous dream. It's a nightmare. But where do we hide from a nightmare? See, where do we hide from a nightmare? How can we find refuge from this nightmare? So, of course, I've been working on this my whole life. And this morning, I took it even further. We've been taking great steps here. We've been going big, really big. And we'll go even bigger here. But most may find it's too much. It's too much. Like, whoa, I don't understand. Well, just get used to the idea. Get used to the idea and stay in neutral mode. Say, okay, let me just have an open mind about this. I am a refugee. I'm fleeing a terrible nightmare, a dream of death. And I can't seem to find refuge. Wherever I go, the ego is still there. The dream, the arrogance, it's still pursuing me, and I don't know how to escape it. Well, where is the one place that this false notion of success, which we feel is proving that arrogance isn't arrogant, where's the one place we can go where that cannot go, where that cannot follow us, where we're safe from it at last, safe from it? We can relax and say, oh my gosh, that was horrible, but I'm finally safe from arrogance and this hideous dream. Where? There's a place. There's a place. And it ties in with what's called the negations that we've been doing. We've been doing assertions, but there's both positive and negative assertions. Well, and the most intense and effective are actually the negations, because what we're doing is we're letting go of our false idea of success. Okay, that is how we find sanctuary from this hideous false idea of success, of proving that arrogance isn't arrogant, this dream of death. Okay, so we let go of our false idea of success. Okay, and how do we do this? Because success is just conceptual. It's all conceptual. It's all symbolic. It's all conceptual. And we can make this negation, this negative assertion, which helps empty our mind of concepts. We say, I take refuge in absolute total failure, in total complete failure. I take refuge in total complete failure, total complete failure. I take refuge in total complete failure. Okay, total complete failure of what? Of our false idea of success, right? We have this false idea of success that we have been pursuing, and we're trying so desperately to succeed with this false idea of success. So as long as we carry this false idea of success with us, we will feel that the universe has us in its jaws, this nightmare. We're still living a nightmare, still dreaming a nightmare. But when we completely set down this false idea of success, we're free of it. And so this false idea of success, what is that but failure? Total, complete failure. So I take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. From the standpoint that we're used to, dropping all idea of success would be total, complete failure. And that's the one place the ego can't go. That's the one place the ego cannot pursue us. It has to stop at that borderland and can't go any further. Because to go any further would undo the ego. There'd be no more ego. Because we're abiding in the land of total complete failure. You See, we are abiding in the land of total, complete failure. Now, when I started practicing this morning, I immediately felt relief. And it was the most profound practice I've ever done. And I said, oh, wow, this is it. Wow. Because when we let go of any notion that we have a success, what is left? What is left is what God created us as, which is the I Am presence. I am. When we let go of everything that we have thought of as success, all thoughts, images, projections, dreams, whatever, of success, when we let go of all of that and accept total, complete failure, I'm abiding in total, complete failure, what God created us as remains. So this is the secret that the teachers have been trying to tell us, and I looked this just before taping. I looked in this book, Journey Beyond Words, and this is what Jesus is saying. This is what Jesus is saying, and thank God for Jesus to emphasize this for us. Otherwise, we might have too much trepidation and say, "Well, no, I need to find some sort of special success. My success hasn't been special enough." Now, let go. So, this is what Jesus is advocating. And we've finally gotten to it. We've finally gotten to it. He said, let go of all thoughts you have of right and wrong. Let go even of that which you have learned in this Course in Miracles. Let go and be still within. And in that stillness shall come rushing toward you, within you, and through you, a mighty wind that shall be the breath of God and shall be nothing more than your own awareness of what you are as the Son of God. Nothing more than your awareness in that instant that indeed this is what you have always been and that is what you shall always be. In that instant, as you relax and still your mind, in that instant shall be your freedom and your salvation. And you will recognize that it took no effort whatsoever, only the letting go of all that you value. All that you value. And so the statement, I take refuge in total, complete failure, meaning I've let go of everything that I value. Okay, and we conceptualize this as total, complete failure. Wow. No success at all. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Now, since I was just practicing it for the first time, there wasn't this mighty rushing wind. But I did feel this aha moment. And I felt like, oh my gosh, this is it. This is the one place the ego would never tell you to look. Never tell you to look here. How can you find success in absolute total failure? You see, the ego will tell you you're absolutely crazy if you look at it there. The ego will say, the ego's belief system starts with, you know, it's absolutely crazy to look for success in total complete failure. Therefore, your very sanity depends on you not looking there, not taking refuge there. That's the basis of his belief system. So in order to protect this belief system, it insists that you not look here. So of course, when you do look here, there's a great strain and stress because the ego is everything you've ever been taught, everything you've taught yourself, every lesson that you have learned, taught yourself, is telling you, you don't dare go here. This will be your undoing. This will be your undoing. Well, it hasn't been my undoing at all. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. Far from being my undoing, I'm like saying, wow, this is it. This is great. But there may not be more. There may be very few in this world who's ever been here who will agree with you on this. Will agree with us on this. But keep in mind, that we are truly refugees, and there will be so many more soon who realize, who will accept refugee status, say, hey, you know, I really feel like I'm a refugee. Where can I find peace of mind? Where can I find peace of mind? We find peace of mind in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure of the entire universe, of everything, absolutely everything I've ever thought, ever dreamed. Total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. Not almost total, complete, but total, complete failure. See, there's no more ego there. There's no more ego. And so the ego tells us if we say this, we will be no more, because the ego thinks that it is us. The ego thinks that is us, that it is our identity. So if we take refuge in total, complete failure, the ego say, well, you'll be annihilated. There's nothing left. Wrong. What's left is what God created us as. God didn't create us as ego. Okay. So this gives the lie to the ego. Okay. I take refuge in total, complete failure. If you have the courage to say it, then say it. I take refuge in total, complete failure. And you'll find that you don't poof disappear. You say, ah, fine, I'm fine. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. But certainly it is the shock of shocks. This is the one thing that you've been told, never, ever, ever entertain this idea. I take refuge in total, complete failure. So we have been taught so strongly that this will result in our annihilation, that when we even come close to this, we get very nervous. It's very frightening. So of course, if we're practicing this, there is a residual fear lingering there that makes us tired. There's no question about it. This is the help where teachers help out, teachers of God, those who've taken refuge, they can help out, because they can give reassurance. And that helps with the shock. Well, there's no question that this is a shocker. The last place you would ever look to take refuge is actually the place where you can find refuge. You can find sanctuary. We've been searching for sanctuary in all the wrong places. Very hot day today, 98 degrees. I'm expecting it to cool down, but it really isn't. Just like the world, it's not really cooling down at all, is it? And actually, you know, the situation in the world is so terrible now that if you don't recognize that, you know, you're seeking refuge, you're a refugee from, then, you know, it'll have to get even more intense. Hopefully, you have recognized it, says, hey, I'm a refugee. You know, I'm fleeing a land full of conflict. Right? Just like refugees in any situation. I think we just heard that the India and Bangladesh came to some accord about these refugee camps that have been there since the war in Bangladesh. Bangladesh was fighting against Pakistan for its independence. And actually, it was even before that. Anyway, there's a lot of refugees from what used to be East Pakistan, which used to be East Bengal, and now we call it Bangladesh, into India, and they were like a no man's zone there, and they took refugee. Well, they were fleeing persecution, they were fleeing conflict. Bad conditions, really bad conditions. Just like right now, we have a massive refugee situation in the United States from Mexico and Latin America. Massive. They're fleeing extreme violence, extreme conflict, extremely bad situations. They're saying, "Wow, let's get out of here. Where can we go?" But this world, this whole world, you might have the Greeks looking for places to go. In fact, they are fleeing to Turkey. Various places, as their country implodes. Hopefully they can get an agreement, but you know, it's looking a little dicey. And even then, their economy is horrible. And so they're fleeing in various places, you know, fleeing conflict, fleeing bad conditions. But this world is more than just bad physical conditions. It's bad spiritual conditions. Hideous teaching in this world, terrible teaching in this world. The ego is just constantly churning out awful, false teaching in this world, desperately trying to build a positive self-image of success. Like, yes, we can find success in this dream. This is very bad teaching. See, so the ideology of the world is going into hell here, and hellish condition, horrible. So we're ideological refugees, right? We're desperately saying, wow, we just got to get away from all this very bad advice that the ego is giving. Call it the Eve deception, if you want to, which is saying, oh yeah, we can find a way to prove that arrogance isn't arrogant. We'll be able to convince arrogance of that. We just have to be real nice and sweet and kind and loving and speak from the heart and, you know, just be able to relate to arrogance in the right way and have a positive relationship with arrogance, and then we will be able to convince it and prove to it. Say, look, it's proven to you. We've proven arrogance that you are not arrogant. And we just have to have the right ones, the right marketers, you know, the right marketing campaign and all this. And this is the Eve deception. This is the egoic deception. And it's so strong now that you can cut it with a knife. And it's unrelenting, absolutely unrelenting. So this is why my efforts have been unrelenting, and hopefully yours have been too, to come upon and find refuge from this, find refuge. So take it very seriously that you're a refugee. And people think, oh gosh, that's so terrible, you're a refugee, you know. Well, sometimes refugees find a real nice haven, don't they? And in this case, we certainly will. We certainly will. Now, most refugees are not up to speed on this. And it's quite difficult. It is true. It is quite difficult to turn around all advice you've ever gotten from the ego that we've given ourselves on how to succeed and drop all of that. You see, that is not easy. But we can at least accept that this is what we need to do. Okay. And so this is what I've done. I at least accepted that Jesus was telling me true. And I said, this is the right advice. I just don't know how to do it. I don't know how long it's going to take, how difficult it will be. But I feel like, indeed, you know, this is the right advice. We're getting the right advice, finally. And then you feel, okay, well, I'm a refugees, when they take refuge in a place, they try to live there, they try to get used to the place where they're at, right? And accept the ways and means of that place. And so this is what we do. We take refuge in total, complete failure. We take refuge in the I Am presence. We spend time trying to get more and more familiar with the I Am presence, with letting go of whatever it is that is distracting us from that. And so we have some guidelines for that. And hopefully there'll be refugee centers around the world, spiritual centers that are, you know, spiritual refugee camps. I feel there's a tremendous need for this, and there will be way more going forward. People will just start snapping and say, wait a minute, this is just all too much here. And this, I don't know what's wrong, but it's too much. I just need to find sanctuaries, you know, spiritual sanctuary. So I put up some guidelines about that, and we can start looking at the situation as determined as a refugee situation. I take refuge in absolute, total failure. Absolute total failure is my salvation. Absolute total failure is my safety. Absolute total failure. I let go. I accept absolute total failure. I accept absolute total failure. I take refuge in absolute total failure. I abide in absolute total failure. And it's so extraordinary, because instead of feeling defeated, you feel like you are being saved. As long as we're trying to accomplish the impossible, we're always going to feel defeated. We're going to have this feeling like, wow, I'm just not succeeding. I'm defeated. I feel so defeated. But when we let go of that effort, we're also letting go of the defeat, the feeling of being defeated. We cannot prove to arrogance that it's not arrogant. So the attempt to do so is to feel constantly defeated. And we try to combat that by trying to build a positive self-image of success. But that's just a painting over, whitewashing over the feeling of defeat. We all feel defeated, don't we? We all feel so defeated. And we don't realize that to embrace total, complete failure also is to let go of defeat. We recognize this plan that we've been doing is nothing but total failure, total complete failure. So I abide in the recognition and acceptance of this total complete failure. And when we set that effort down, we also set defeat down. Okay. So as we practice this, we may find that the feeling of being defeated sort of is like we're letting go of that too. I don't feel so defeated anymore. And again, this is entirely counter to the ego's advice to us. And the ego says, well, I can't help you anymore because you've lost me. Truly lost me. Yeah. So, yeah, I accept total, complete defeat. I accept total, complete defeat. I take refuge in total, complete defeat. Failure. Total, complete failure. Let's put it that way. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Complete defeat. This effort has been completely defeated. I accept that. Absolutely, totally, completely defeated. Total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. And therefore, there's no thinking about it, because it's we're not making exceptions. No, total, complete failure. And again, to accept this and entertain this is, it may be more than most can do right at this moment. But at least, again, you can get used to this idea that, like, hey, maybe this is so. Maybe, like, reading Jesus, what Jesus says, I say, wow, really? Well, relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. And that's the answer. Well, yeah, maybe it is. Maybe I think he's right. But I'm not sure. You know, can I do this? You know, it takes a while, and you have to, you know, keep working at it. But let it start seeping into you. There is a place of refuge. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. And so there's such a wow, such a shock, astonishment at this, that it, you know, it doesn't smooth out necessarily immediately, and we shouldn't expect it to. You know, that's why I say, don't give up. If you're practicing truth, don't give up just because you don't immediately, you know, have the mighty wind rushing in and you're all free. Now, it could happen if you really just let it go and say, yeah, okay. But you're more likely to first initially feel that this is it. And also, like, whoa, wow, the wow reaction. As we've always talked about, the wow reaction. And this is why I've talked about it, is managing our success. And when we get to the point of, like, this total success by abiding in total complete failure, okay, of the egoic agenda, of course, it's such a shock. It is such a shock. And this, unfortunately, my work, I don't have hardly any work at this moment. So I'm able to sleep, rest a lot in the afternoon. I'm able to tape. I'm able to, I slept in late this morning. I was actually practicing this for hours and hours and hours. And then I had to take a rest, and now I'm taping. So it's giving me an opportunity to bring this forward here as we are now on the 25th of June, 2015, which is now we are in this 1 year period, this 1 year grace period where we must take refuge. Refugees must begin to, you know, to find their shelter, their refuge, their sanctuary. So just a couple days into it, we've gone really big. And this has been my goal, to go big like this. Keep in mind, as we get used and accept this, truly accept it and get relaxed with it. Say, okay, this is where I am now. I'm abiding in this total, complete failure. We then will begin to be aware of the I Am presence. This is how I see it. The dawn of the kingdom of now will begin to dawn upon us. Again, don't worry if you're feeling skittish, too little skittish. It will gradually will sink in. But all the work that we've been doing before has helped lead us to this point where we did positive affirmations, so many positive affirmations. We keep in mind our root affirmation, it starts out with a negation, right? I am not a body. So it starts out with this negation, and then it fills it in saying, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. So the ultimate affirmations are these negative affirmations of I take refuge, I take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. But really, it's a super positive. It's such a super positive that, but the way we have to go about it is through this negation, of completely negating all notions, values, belief in success that we've been believing in for so long, that somehow we have to succeed at this endeavor of proving that arrogance isn't arrogant. Somehow we need to succeed at this. We have to set all of that, let go of all of that, relax our mind, release our thoughts, and let them go. And indeed, all thoughts that we've been thinking have to do with this impossible success we're pursuing. And so, in letting them all go, what is left but exactly what as God created us? I'm spirit. I'm not a body. I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. Take refuge in that. There's no question that those who have come to watch these videos are seeking refuge. Absolutely, we're all refugees. And many are those who have been feeling this for a long time, and a long time refugees looking for, seeking, you know, where can I take refuge? Because the world is a monster. The universe is a monster. It's a dream of death. It's a dream of annihilation, a dream of destruction. We're trying to prove to arrogance, hey, you're not wrong, arrogance, that you can destroy reality. Look at this dream. Look at this universe. See, you did this. This is yours. We're gifting it to you. Or you just don't know that you actually did it. We're just trying to, once we convince you that you're responsible, you're the author of this, then you'll say, oh, okay, I guess I'm not arrogant, you know. So it truly calls upon all our expertise, be able to handle this. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Or you can say, I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. There you go. That's another way of putting it. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Or I am a total, complete failure. In other words, the effort to change I am, which is really what this whole dream of the universe is a total, complete failure. the idea that we can create a new I am of our own, separate from God, is a total, complete failure. So I am, which we're associating with our thoughts and concepts, I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. Hallelujah. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Try practicing that sometime. Maybe when you wake up in the middle of the night from a nightmare or something, just say, hey, wait a minute, I'm going to take refuge in total, complete failure. The universe can't get me there, can it? It can't reach me there. And yet we're not alone there. We're not alone. Gradually the I Am presence will dawn upon us. So, the ego has made a lot of false idols out of Jesus. But we have Jesus to thank for leading us to this sanctuary. Absolutely. Absolutely. We have the Holy Spirit to thank. Absolutely. I am absolute complete failure. I am an absolute complete failure. Yes, I am an absolute complete failure. Absolute complete failure. Total complete failure. I am total complete failure. I am absolute total complete failure. I am absolute total complete failure. And of course, the ego will be shrieking, "Oh, that's not sanctuary! What are you talking about? You know, no, I have a nice sanctuary for you." Oh, really? Where? Where in the ego's domain is there a sanctuary for us? Doesn't exist. Doesn't exist. I am total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Thank you, God, for the total complete failure of this insane idea I had of trying to be great, be greater than you, be the creator, God. I take refuge in total complete failure. Has there ever been anyone take refuge in total complete failure? Anyone at all? I mean, we're saying, well, this is great. It sounds good, right? It sounds right. I said, yeah. If you actually practice it, it'll start to dawn upon you that, you know, this is actually right. And you say, wow, is this, you know, anyone ever done? Well, sure. Let's take a look and see if we can pull something up here. Oh, there you go. Examples of I Am presence. And who we pulled up here, Ramana Maharshi. Okay, Ramana Maharshi was most certainly an example of taking refuge in total complete failure in the I Am presence. And what was left was I Am presence. Ramana gave up everything. He gave up death. He said, this is all nothing. The world is nothing. The body is nothing. Total complete failure, right? Yeah. And what was left? I Am presence. I Am presence was what was left. I Am presence. I Am presence. And he rarely said anything at all. He just was like looking like this, just as you're seeing him now. If you went to see him in Tiruvannamalai, Arunachala, Ramanashram, he would just be just like this. Just like this. Almost as still as a statue. Not saying a word. Not moving, not saying a word. And yet the people who went to see him said that it was the most profound experience they've ever come across. And it was just like an enormous force, an enormous presence that was communicating with them totally. Ramana said that the most powerful communication is silence, because it's not a lack of communication. It's saying everything to you. It says everything. So there's a great example, awesome example that we've had just recently. Okay, so we're talking about recently. Well, when he passed the dropped the body in the 1950-ish, Okay, but was here for the, you know, the first half of the 20th century. Let's see. Well, I've lost some of the. I will keep looking at Ramana for right now. And here's another. Here's another. Here's another. Here's another I am present example of I am presence. Ananda Maima, a contemporary Ramana Maharshi, dropped the body in 1982. There's no question that Ananda Maima was abiding in the I am presence. Absolutely abiding in the I am presence. In fact, never ever identified with this dream, this nightmare, the consciousness of the flesh, never ever identify with her, even for a moment, just constant abidance in the I am presence. And it's so powerful, it's difficult to deal, you know, it's difficult to to experience this. Difficult to experience this, but gradually we'll get used to it. Gradually we'll get used to the I am presence. But so there's another example, okay, of the I am presence. Well, this, when I put the pictures in, they got some disappeared on me. Well, here's one. Here's one. Which one is this? Examples of an I am presence. Aha! Our great and beloved brother and friend, Jesus Christ, who is the one that is truly clarifying for us where we can take refuge 2,000 years ago. Mighty I am presence. Mighty I am presence. The one who is doing so much work to help us, such great work. Take refuge in absolute, total, complete failure. Here's another one, I am presence, a little different style, Nisargadatta Maharaj, living in what, Mumbai, Bombay, up until in the 80s, he dropped his body sometime in the 80s, I believe. He had sort of a feisty temperament, but behind that was the I am presence. The I am presence was there, absolutely. Absolutely. And let's see if I can find any other, or... Well, it looks like it's gone hiding. That's okay. Anyway, there have been others. There have been others. And we can be this way too, as a matter of fact. We can be this way too. The I am presence. We can take refuge in absolute total failure and abide in this wonderful I am presence. That which does not require any concept for it to be there. Does not require any concept for it to be there. It is there. Has always been there. As Jesus says, we don't need to do anything for it to be there. We just need to let go of all our concepts and thoughts. And we will realize that it has always been there. This is the secret. This is the secret. And the more we can accept this, you know, the better it will be for us. I'm going through all these pictures. Maybe I should just go through all these pictures for you. Should we do that? Maybe. Maybe, maybe. I'm thinking about it. Maybe this whole thing has been so intense that maybe that would be helpful. Maybe it would be helpful. Just to help cool us down, right? Because yeah, this is so intense. It is to take refuge in total complete failure. It is an absolute shock. So maybe I can go through these pictures. Let me see. There's so many of them though. I never did find the one I was looking for. Shall we do that? Just kick back and give yourself like a treat. And wow, you say, wow, I finally heard what I needed to hear. I finally heard it. I finally heard it. I didn't think I'd ever hear it here. I finally heard it. Take refuge in total complete failure. I am total complete failure. All right. So let's go through these. Let's go through these pictures if we can. There's all sorts of different pictures here. Just enjoy. I am total complete failure. Take refuge, Jesus. Here, come to my sanctuary, the sanctuary. Now I have some, there's some slides that have some words on them. I don't know. I can't say exactly. We're walking together in the wow. Welcome, everyone. We're walking together in the wow. We're taking sanctuary in the wow, right? Absolutely. Let's walk together in the wow. Let us walk together in the wow. The prison bars have already vanished without a trace. My perception is now totally holistic. There you go. Prison bars have already vanished without a trace. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Truly, I am free. Praise be to God. Truly, I am free. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. What's this one? I think we already had this one. Oh yeah, okay. And I can't really see what they... Oh, that's Jerusalem. That's old Jerusalem there. let's see. Which way are we going here? I am truly free. I am truly free. Yes, I am. I am truly free. I am free as I've taken refuge in total complete failure. Wonderful. Ah, Jesus is feeding the multitudes there. East of the Sea of Galilee, it looks like. And, yeah. Look at these. Refugees, right? Perfect example. Look at this. Refugees. Refugees. That is what we're seeing here. And Jesus says, don't worry, I'll feed you. I'll feed you. Don't worry. And now Jesus is walking along a road here, pathway here. And He's telling them, hey, yes, you can take refuge. There is a way to take refuge. Absolutely there is. Oh, that's a map. That's a map of old Jerusalem, huh? Yeah. Or just, what is a delightful... I try to be greater than God by seeing a flaw in reality, but this was only a hallucination. God has always remained perfect. Oh, there's nice words, huh? Absolutely. Yeah, we sort of updated this by recognizing that we've been trying to prove that arrogance is not arrogant. And Jesus is having a nice powwow here, a nice talk with the apostles here. And explaining to them, hey, you can take refuge. Absolutely, you can. And they weren't quite ready for it. Well, they were, trying, but wow. This is actually a repeat of that in higher definition. Let's see. Yeah, that's higher definition. Okay. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Absolutely. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for the healed perception I am now experiencing. Stay engaged every day with clarifying truth, okay? Stay engaged every day with clarifying truth. When you're a refugee, you're a refugee, and you need to stay engaged every day with clarifying truth. And keep reminding yourself, where was sanctuary? Spaciousness, that's a very wonderful book by Longchamp, translated by Keith Dowman. By Longchamp, absolutely. And in fact, we're going to even see a slide of this book. Spaciousness, there you go. The I Am Presence. Spaciousness, pure spaciousness. Is the I Am Presence. Absolutely it is. Pure spaciousness is the I Am Presence. Take refuge, take refuge, take refuge. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. I am already free. Healed perception has restored my mind to sanity. Okay. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. And this is something illustrating a Bible story, I think. Whatever it is, the light is there. The light is there. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Wow, what a nice slide this is. There's no particular order for these slides whatsoever. It keeps mixing them all up, and so it's fine. Whatever pops up is great. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Take refuge in absolute, total failure. All right? Our plans to prove that arrogance isn't arrogant is an absolute total failure. So I take refuge in absolute total failure. I take refuge in absolute total failure. So I'm relaxing my mind, releasing my thoughts, and letting them go. All concepts, you know, good and bad. All thought concepts of accomplishment, success, attainment. Yeah, all of those. No, I take refuge in absolute total failure. This is just a wonderful background. Absolute total failure. There's no thoughts or concepts there, right? No thoughts or concepts there. Just a little reminder that we're going on a journey beyond words here when Jesus is helping us out with this. Okie dokie. Enjoy. And we're looking for... Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. Okay. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Now I see truly. My perception is healed. My vision is holy. Absolutely. I already know that I am perfectly abiding in the one and only truth. That there is no fixation whatsoever. I am absolutely free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. A new dispensation is here now. Absolutely it is. This is the new dispensation. We're taking sanctuary. We're taking refuge. There is no finish line. There is no race. There is no contest. There is no winning. There is no losing. See? So take refuge in absolute, total failure. Absolute, total failure of this race. Okay? There's no finish line. There's no finish line. There's no success. You can't even successfully fail at it. It's only in absolute, complete, total failure that we find salvation from it. New dispensation called abiding in non-dual truth. Practice to reach this goal. Full stop in the wow practice. Yes. As refugees, this is what we aiming for. Our aim is to abide in the non-dual truth, abide in the I am-ness. We need to practice to reach this goal. And we must remember full stop in the wow practice. This is what we do, full stop in the wow practice. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Now, I don't remember this one so much. Yeah. But wow, that's nice. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. And there you go. Absolute total failure. Let's abide in absolute total failure. Wonderful, actually. Anyways, I can't remember these slides. It's a very nice one. Okay, and then there's a variation on it. Beautiful. Beautiful. I abide in absolute total failure. And Jesus is saying to the apostles as they're struggling with their nets and struggling out, they says, hey, come on, come on, come on in, come on in, come on in. You're finding absolute total failure there, so accept absolute total failure. Okay, that's fine, that's great. Ah, but I say unto you, love your enemies. Bless them that curse you, and do good to them that hate you. And pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. Absolutely. Agree with your adversary quickly. We've been doing this practice. No matter how the ego reviles us, we agree, we agree, we agree. Ego says, you're completely crazy to say you're abiding in total failure. So, yes, I'm completely crazy to say I'm abiding in total, complete failure. And this is Jesus going into Jerusalem. Palm Sunday, it looks like. Okay. There we have a title page for Longchenpa, the great Longchenpa, who abided as the I Am Presence. Who abided as the I Am Presence. Hanging out in Tibet. And here we have a nice background. Beautiful, serene background. Just take refuge in total, complete failure. Take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. Not I am a failure. See, don't say I am a failure. Well, we can say, I am a total complete failure. Not, I am a failure. Or, you know, I have this failure here. This is terrible. No, total complete failure. Total complete failure. Total complete failure. So, here we have Tissot painting of the three wise men. Beautiful painting. Look at that. I take refuge in total complete failure. Take refuge in total, complete failure. This is Jesus in the Sea of Galilee here. They're struggling, being overwhelmed, their concepts or their ideas. For the truth of our freedom is in God, is always knocking at our door. Right. So I've got the answer. Hey, you guys are trying to take refuge in success. Take refuge in total, complete failure. Take refuge in total, complete failure. Take refuge in total, complete failure. It's very fashionable to mock Jesus these days, isn't it? Very fashionable, because the ego is... thinks it's winning. It thinks that, oh, okay, we're winning now, so we can really let Jesus have it. You know, he's really caused us problems, but no. Take refuge in total, complete failure. Ah. There's the good shepherd. Says, hey, take refuge in total, complete failure. I am there. I am there. I am is there. Everything that God created is real. Everything that God did not create is not real. Truth is true. Nothing else is true. Jesus at the Cove of Parables here, where he's giving some profound advice to the people near Capernaum, just south of Capernaum, on the west side, northwest of the Sea of Galilee here. Yes. Journey beyond words indeed. Journey beyond words indeed. You see, I'm a total, complete failure. What words need to be put to that? What music can you put to that? Nothing, right? What music can you put? I'm a total, complete failure. That's the end of explanation, isn't it? It's the end of words, the end of concepts. I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Can get this one to move. There you go. Take refuge. I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. And we may think, oh, I'll feel terrible. No, you don't feel terrible. You actually start to feel some hope. We're journeying beyond words. You see, words are trying to teach us, train us. Okay, you can have success this way, success that way. So we go to school, they teach us. Here's how to get a positive self-image. You're going to be a successful kid, aren't you? You're going to grow. When you grow up, you're going to be very successful. Instead, we grow up and be very depressed. I am a total, complete failure. Yes, I already know that I am a total, complete failure. Yes, I already know that I am a total, complete failure. Yes, I already thank you, Holy Spirit, for guiding us to where the ego will never guide us to. All right, by showing us where we can, where the sanctuary is, where we would never think to look on the advice of the ego and on familiarity and on habit. We would never think to look in accepting total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. See, the ego cannot accept this, but we can. So that's why we realize we're not the ego. The ego is not us. Because we can accept this. Whereas the ego, no way. No way. No way. It will always say, well, I've got some success. I think I know a way to succeed. No, there's no way to succeed in proving that arrogance isn't arrogant. I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. Thank you again. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for guiding our minds, guiding and helping us in this refugee situation, taking refuge from the universe, actually taking refuge from the universe. This universal dream, this universal dream of death. This universal dream of arrogance. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Absolutely. Greatly appreciated. And we will continue to appreciate it and appreciate it and appreciate it as we settle into our sanctuary of abidance and total, complete failure. Abidance and total, complete failure, total, complete failure, total, complete failure, total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. And yet what is there? The I Am presence that we didn't make. We didn't make it. It's inherently there. It's the one thing that we cannot set down. We can let go of everything, and what is left? That is what we truly are. So let go of everything. So say, I am total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. I have let go of everything. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Wonderful. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. I take refuge in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. accept your status as a refugee. You have refugee status. We have refugee status. Yes, we do. We have refugee status. We have refugee status. We have refugee status. As we just go through these slides, I have refugee status. I have refugee status. I am a total complete failure. I've accepted that I'm a total complete failure. Now, you know, some would say self-surrender. They call it total self-surrender. Same, they're talking about the same basic. Basically, there's a basic similarity there, but we won't struggle with words. I am a total complete failure, taking refuge in the fact that I am a total complete failure. Total complete failure is my sanctuary thought. See, the ego cannot get me there. It can't get me there. And yet I'm not alone there. I am not alone. I am presence. So this is fun. It helps a little bit. It is very intense. I understand. I'm feeling it. Very intense. The backlash, you know, the wow factor comes in, and we think, oh my gosh, maybe I'm going to get pulled away from this. But no, we'd stay with it. There was a game today, a baseball game, and the Giants were leading 9-2 in the eighth inning, and they said, oh, we got this one. But the San Diego Padres came back and scored 6 runs in the eighth inning, and it was 9-8, and they were threatening to get more, and it was like, whew. And then the Giants came back and scored a whole 4 more runs in the eighth inning, and they pulled away. At least I hope they did, because I didn't see the final top of the ninth inning, but I assume that they held on. And so you're thinking, oh my gosh, we got this great lead, but we're going to lose it. No, just keep your cool. The backlash will occur, okay? The backlash will occur. But we're not bothered by that. Ah, wonderful picture, wonderful graphic here. I am presence. Thank you, Jesus. Experiencing the I am presence. Absolutely. Wow. Interesting. It doesn't want to go to the next slide. There it goes. Okay. Wow. Very powerful. I am presence. I am a total failure. I am a total complete failure. I am a total complete failure. How about that? Isn't that great? Hallelujah. This is the one thing that every parent, every educator, every friend will insist you not say, right? The only one who will allow us to say this, not the only, well, is the I am presence. Jesus will allow us to say this. The others, the ones who have realized I am presence, will allow us to say this, absolutely. But let's just use Jesus as an example. Jesus absolutely will advocate this for you. So he's a true friend. See, this is a true friend here. We're paying attention to. So it's a good idea to find out who your real friends are. Very good idea to find out who your real friends are. And oh, what a friend we have in Jesus. That is a fact. What a friend we have in Jesus. Oh, I like this one too. Wow. What a friend we have in Jesus. Believe it. Believe it. Don't let these mockers derail you at all. You know, they think they're strong in their mockery, but they are merely mocking idols and that they have made. You know, they make idols, then they mock them. Well, what is that? What does that have to do with Jesus? Absolutely nothing. So they're just mocking the idols that they have in their mind, the idols of success they have in their mind, ridiculing. Say, ah, you told me I'd be successful, but I'm not successful. You know, this is what they believe, that they believe that Jesus told them, you know, we got to be successful in the world, you know, and they say, ah, I can't be successful in this world. This is awful. This is terrible. Jesus doesn't know. Well, they're not listening to Jesus. Okay, they're listening to the ego's interpretation of Jesus. Because they cannot conceive that success ultimately, sanctuary is found in total complete failure. Total complete failure. So, Jesus' message is lost upon them. They just say, no, that's the one place where for sure Jesus is not talking about that. We know that for sure Jesus is not talking about except taking, abiding in total complete failure, taking refuge in total complete failure. Say for sure. So we'll rule that out for sure. And that, so we're just by process of elimination, we'll eventually come upon it. So the ego starts out by ruling out the truth to start with. And says, okay, we will rule this out for sure. We know that can't be right. And now let's go search for the truth. And so we've been searching for the truth for so long, and we can't find it. And so we get real mad at Jesus. Say, Jesus, we thought you would help us find the truth, and we haven't found it yet. And Jesus will say, well, have you been, you know, doing what I told you to do? And, yeah, well, are you taking refuge in total complete failure? Relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them all go. Well, we can't do that. That obviously that will annihilate us. Do you say no? No. Who told you that? Who told you that? Who told you that? Well, Jesus said it was the ego that told you that. It's arrogance that's telling you that. I didn't say listen to arrogance. Jesus said I didn't say listen to arrogance. No. There's some, I'm not sure, there's some credit that on this picture background, but I'm claiming fair use, religious education, nonprofit religious education here, spiritual education for it, but thank you for this picture. It's a, yeah. Take refuge in total, complete failure. Take refuge in total, complete failure. So, yeah, the world is mocking the advice of the ego. The ego mocks its own advice, but claiming that the advice, you know, it really came from Jesus. The ego says, well, this has to be the advice. It. What else could it be? Take refuge in total, complete failure. How about that advice? How about that advice? Take refuge in total, complete failure. How about that advice? Ego said, you can't be serious. Oh, yes, we are, absolutely. Total, complete failure is my salvation. Total, complete failure is my salvation. Total, complete failure is my salvation. And being that you're a refugee, you understand this. You know, you say, yeah, I get it. The ego won't get it, though. The universe won't get this. That is for sure. The universe will not get this. The universe will not get it, but we get it. Jesus gets it. Absolutely. What a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. Totally gets it. Totally gets it. I take refuge in total, complete, unequivocal, absolute failure. And the I Am presence will begin to dawn upon us. That which can never fail because God created it as truth. God's will can never fail. God's will can never fail. I Am presence. Take refuge. Take refuge. Take refuge. Take refuge. from the stormy seas. Take refuge from the universe. Take refuge from all this weary battle and effort we've put forth to find success. We're still, you know, where can I find success? I can't find it anywhere. You know, what's wrong with me? I'm stupid. I must be stupid. I must be crazy. I can't find success. I can take refuge in absolute, total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. No more search, huh? No more search for success. It's finished. No more search for success. So, Jesus is still knocking at our door. Still, have you got? Come on out! Come on out of your hiding. You're in this dark room searching for success. You know, this dark universe, this dream. You're having a dream. Wake up from the dream. Come on. You say, "Oh no, I gotta succeed first, though." He says, "No, no, no. Just accept, abide in total, complete failure. It's okay. You didn't have to succeed. You didn't have to prove the arrogance wasn't arrogant." I loose the world from all I thought it was. See? Everything that I thought the world, I loose the world, I let go of that, I let go of that. I loose the world from all that I thought it was. I am not a body, I am free, I am still spirit, exactly as God created me. Exactly as God created me. I already know my perception is already healed. I know it's already healed, right? The I Am Presence is already there, isn't it? The I Am Presence is already there. A parable of the sower, it looks like. Yeah, wonderful parable. Wonderful parable. We've gone over that many times. Throwing seeds upon, you know, rocks. The birds get them. Holy Spirit, heal perception. Holy Spirit, heal perception. Holy Spirit, heal perception. Absolutely. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Holy Spirit, vision of sameness. Vision of sameness. When we stop our insane quest for success, we will certainly have the vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of oneness. Holy Spirit, vision of Christ. We absolutely have the Holy Spirit vision of Christ. The I Am Presence. Holy Spirit, vision of I Am Presence. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Holy Spirit, healed perception. Healed perception is my only goal, and I have already arrived. You see? Feel that. Abiding in total, complete failure is my only goal, and I've already arrived. I don't need to do anything. I'm already total. I am already a total, complete failure. I've already attained healed perception. Yes, I'm already total, complete failure. I don't have to do anything. I don't have to do anything. Just because I accept it. I accept it. I accept it. I accept it. The ego can't accept it, but I accept it. Healed perception. Healed perception. Finally, I'm not looking for what doesn't exist. See, success in the context of ego doesn't exist. It doesn't exist. Doesn't exist. So, I'm trying to find it. Can't find it. The Good Shepherd. The Good Shepherd. Another background. Here is an example of the I Am Presence. Example of the I Am Presence here. There you go. There you go. That is the I Am Presence. Just saying, I'm here. I'm here. Don't worry. Set down all notions of success, and I am here. The I Am Presence will be there. Don't worry. Don't worry, don't worry, don't worry. No concerns. What do we have here? We're going to go to... come to the oasis, the I Am Oasis. Just come to the I Am Oasis. Welcome, welcome, we welcome you here. We welcome you to the sanctuary. You will find refuge here. Relax, relax, relax your mind, release your thoughts and let them go. You're at peace here, you're at peace. You're at peace, be not concerned. Total complete failure is only in regard to attempting to accomplish the impossible. Welcome. We've been expecting you. Absolutely, we have been expecting you. It's all peaceful, it's all beautiful. Welcome. This welcome home. Welcome to your refuge. Welcome to your refuge. Welcome to your refuge. May you abide here in peace forever and ever. May you walk here in peace and tranquility and breathe the air of peace and serenity. Absolutely. Welcome, relax. You're safe here. You found the safe haven finally from madness. Really, from madness. So just relax your mind, release your thoughts, and let them go. All is calm, all is serene, all is peaceful, tranquil, quiet, still, no troubles. This is going to stretch out Ramana here, but I'll click this anyway. He's going to stretch him out. So it's going to look... It didn't stretch him out. But great. There, I Am Presence right here. I Am Presence. Okay. This is someone who's taken refuge. I Am Presence. Welcome to the oasis. I Am Presence. I am a presence. Yeah, just relax, just sit. Finally, we have found refuge. Finally, we have found refuge. Calm, peaceful, serene. No troubles. We're no longer, mind is no longer troubled. The universe cannot touch us here. The universe cannot touch us here. It cannot get its hands on us. The nightmare is over. The nightmare is over. So we just sit here calmly, sit here calmly, sit here calmly, and allow the I Am Presence to dawn upon us, the I Am Presence to dawn upon us. We have an example here, again, of I Am Presence. Absolute stillness, absolute calm, absolute peace, totally undisturbed. Example of I Am Presence. We certainly can do it. We certainly can do it. We can take refuge. Absolutely, 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 we can take refuge. Just like take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. Welcome to the sanctuary. Welcome to the sanctuary where you just sit in absolute peace and calm. Absolute peace and calm of the I Am Presence. I'm just clicking through all the slides that I've, you know, loaded into this program from in various times. So we have a place there to relax. Here's another I Am Presence again, Anamima, I Am Presence. Another example, I Am Presence. I Am Presence. This is one who's simply abiding in I Am Presence constantly. This is what you're seeing. You're not seeing some sort of physical beauty here. You're seeing the absolute peace and assurance of I Am Presence. Absolute peace and assurance of I Am Presence. Abide in, I am a total failure. I am a complete, total failure. We use that to release all concepts of success, right? God does not need a concept of our success. We don't need a concept of our success. Our beingness, our I Am-ness is already present within us. So we have a nice, beautiful place here to stay, right? Nice, beautiful place to stay in this refuge. This is not a refuge in squalor, you know. It's not a refuge in squalor and dust and being deprived. No, it's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. It's just a symbol, okay, of the absolute. I think we get a bonus here with Ramana again, another I Am Presence. There we go. Look at this. I Am Presence. I Am Presence right there, right here, right now. I am an absolute total failure right here, right now. Right here, right now. See, what a beautiful place. What a beautiful place it is to take refuge in absolute total failure. Yes, I can. Yes, we can do that. In the waters of peace and tranquility and security and love and freedom are always flowing there. They're always flowing there. As we wander among the palms, just in this quiet elation, you know, just what could be better? And we're going to get another picture here of I Am Presence. I Am Presence again. We're going to come across this I Am Presence again, not in my mind, I Am Presence. This is not just not some beautiful person. This is the I Am Presence. Complete assurance, complete safety, complete assurance. Quiet, peaceful, serene, lovely. There's just an inner landscape of loveliness. Call out the search. Accept, I am a total, complete failure. I am a total, complete failure. This is a key, total and complete. Not, the ego can't do that, can it? So I am a total, complete failure. And I take refuge in this fact. I take refuge in this fact. Take wonderful refuge in this fact. And we're working our way through. Here's another wonderful picture, actually. I Am Presence. In the midst of the jungle, the mountains, Himalayan mountains, the creepers, the vines. Doesn't touch the I Am Presence. It's not bothered. It's total refuge, total sanctuary in the I Am Presence. Here we go. Jesus, I Am Presence. I Am Presence. I Am Presence. That will dawn upon us. Don't force it. Don't look for it. Don't search it. We just keep saying, I'm a total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. I take refuge in that. Okay. And the I Am Presence will gradually dawn upon us. The kingdom of now will dawn upon us. It absolutely will. Now we have some words. The flaw I thought I saw in reality was never there. I now see the perfection that has always been here for me. You see? Absolutely. Absolutely. Familiarity is the key to success, indeed. So we have to keep working at this, right? Over and over and over and over. But every time we do, it's easier. Don't struggle with the struggle. Ah, this is walking together than well. Don't struggle with the struggle. You feel a struggle, just say, great. You know, this is just the price I'm paying to get used to this. So I don't struggle with it. I just full stop in the wow. Coast a little time. The continuity problem is the only problem, right? We just need to get used to this. We're experiencing the continuity problem here as we entertain this Canto 9 resolution that's actually in the book Spaciousness. I don't have to go through all the cantos. Resolution. Well, why not? We're having fun here. What's the next one? We don't know, right? Spontaneity. These are chapters in the book Spaciousness. Spontaneity. Inclusivity. Absolute inclusivity. Okay. Non-causality and non-striving. Non-causality and non-striving. Luminous mind. Very nice. Luminous mind. The simile for luminous mind. Buddha feels. We can just enjoy the graphic too, right? Kanto 13 Buddha. Which means really, I am presence. Buddha is I am presence. Christ is I am presence. Pure spaciousness. Release, 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 release. I am released by absolute total failure. Releases me into the purity of pure spaciousness. Absolute, I am absolute total failure, and this releases me into vision. The vision of the purity of pure spaciousness. The Buddha field of pure spaciousness. Okie dokie. Spaciousness, yeah. We're released into pure spaciousness. We feel the presence of pure spaciousness. Beyond words. We've gone beyond words now. We have gone beyond words. If you're still, I'm feeling the intensity still, very intense, very, very intense. Assertions, full stop on the wow. This is our practice, make assertions, full stop on the wow, flipping the script, okay? So, we're making the assertion, I am total, complete failure. That's an assertion. Now, we're working on this full stop in the wow now, like, wow, this is just stunning. And then our commentary is flipping the script. These are the three aspects of practice. The practice of the refugees from this horrible universe. Oh, that's in downtown Nepal. Kathmandu. That's Kathmandu. Speaking of refugees. Wait a minute. Let's go back. We're just talking about refugees. Well, what about the refugees from this terrible earthquake in Nepal, you know? This is a terrible situation. You think those people don't want refuge from the universe? From this dream of death and destruction? Absolutely they do. I always pray as if I had already received what I want. And I'm thanking God for this. Absolutely. Thank you, God, for sanctuary. We thank you, God, for sanctuary. I already know that I'm already experiencing healed perception. I already know that I found sanctuary. I found the sanctuary. I have already finished the path. Healed perception has already dawned upon my mind. The vision of holiness already graces my vision. I'm already enlightened. That's right. I don't reach enlightenment. I realize I'm already enlightened. We never attain enlightenment. It dawns upon us that we're already enlightened. The I am, we've never left the I am presence. Healed perception is enlightenment, and I am already enlightened. I see, healed perception is enlightenment. I am already enlightened. Today I celebrate my healed perception. We celebrate our sanctuary. We celebrate our refuge. It is a day of holiness. Now all my days are holy. Agree with thine adversary quickly. We have that. We'll do it again. Whilst thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officer, and thou be cast into prison. The prison, of course, of this attempt at egoic success. Whatever the ego says, we agree. Sure. It wants to say that we have no chance to succeed in what we're doing. Yes, ego. Yes, I have no chance to succeed. There you go. Ah, I am presence. Jesus, I am presence. Jesus, I am presence. Holy Spirit, I am presence. Holy Spirit, I am presence. here, sanctuary, 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 sanctuary. And Jesus says, hey, take refuge from the world. Take refuge from the universe. I have a place, you know, you could take refuge from it. Ah, a place of absolute, total failure. Absolute, total failure. Complete, total failure. Complete, total failure. Complete, total failure. Ah. Hey, complete, total failure. Jesus is, see, complete, total failure. Crucifixion, complete, total failure. Take refuge in complete, total failure. What happened? Oh, resurrected. He says, look at me. You can't kill reality. You cannot kill reality. You cannot kill the Son of God. You cannot kill spirit. We cannot kill ourselves. We cannot destroy ourselves. We cannot make arrogance true. So Jesus is happily saying, yeah, yeah, take sanctuary. Absolutely. Isn't it great taking sanctuary? Absolute, complete failure. Absolute, complete failure. Yeah. How wonderful. How wonderful it is. So, we keep moving along. It says, be not concerned, be not concerned. Be not concerned. He's saying, look, I'm free of this nightmare. I'm free of this nightmare. I'm free of this nightmare, and you can be too. Free of the nightmare, and you can be free of the nightmare too. Again, free of this nightmare, and you too can be free of this nightmare. Be not concerned, just accept. I am a total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. Okay? And he's saying, okay, you got it? You got it? Let me tell you one more time. You got it yet? You got it yet? See, I'm not bound by this nightmare anymore. Total, complete failure. And what's left? I am presence is what is left. I am presence is what is left. So the good shepherd protects us from the big bad wolf of the ego, telling us we have to succeed at what's impossible to succeed at. So we give thanks to the I am shepherd. And what is this? I don't know what this is. Some of these, there's a couple of slides I don't know. Let me see. Okay. Some sort of stained glass windows. I'm moving into this. I don't remember these so much, but this is, these are some old. This is Jesus talking. Explaining, hey, take refuge. I am the way. I know the way. I am is the way. I am is here for you. I am here for you. Meaning, I am is here for you. I am is here for you. There's some old place in the Holy Land. I don't know what that is. Well, let us once more. Let us once more recognize Jesus knocking on the door and say, hey, you know, come out from your nightmare. I realize your nightmare is a total, complete failure. A total, complete failure. A total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. So we're getting towards the end here. Here's again an example of the I am presence. Example of the I am presence. This one is again an example of the I am presence. And this one too, example of the I am presence. Now, maybe there's some guidelines for refugees. Let's take a look at this. Take a look at this. See what this slide says. Minimizing the backlash of your success. Well, we've gone through this tremendous video, right? So, practice full stop in the wow. There's some advice how to minimize the backlash. Guard vigilantly against any body thoughts, okay? Don't let the body thoughts take root in any way. Go back to the confession. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Go back to that confession as often as possible. Get plenty of rest. We talked about before. Get plenty of rest. This is very stressful. Don't tackle big complex projects. All right? Stay humble and unassuming. Stay humble and unassuming. And I would add severely modest. Don't pay attention to the news. Don't pay attention to the news. I'm looking at the Greek debt crisis a little bit because this is pretty, but I'm trying to minimize it. It's pretty important stuff in terms of refugee, the idea of, you know, the world unraveling. But don't pay attention to the news. Don't pay attention to the news. Just avoid entertainment. Avoid entertainment. Stay celibate. No body thoughts. Stay celibate. Chaste. Be very chaste. No body thoughts. Okay, this isn't, we're trying to take refuge here. This is extremely important. Extremely important. So to minimize the backlash, you see, to minimize the backlash, these are some very good advice that we're giving to refugees as they come streaming in. I am presence here of Ramana Maharshi. A great, great example of I am presence. It's we're going to take a look here at some advice. I believe the basics. Okay, the basics here are one confession for all. We all have this basic confession of I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body. I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Same for everyone. There's no secret mantras, you know. This is the same basic, the basic confession, the basic assertion, the basic assertion. One basic practice for all. The three parts that the assertions, both affirmation, affirming in the positive, and negative negations. Okay, I like to get. I'm a total complete failure is an example of an assertion that's a negation. Negation assertion. I am a total complete failure. I am total complete failure. All right, this example. Full stop in the wow. As you feel this wow, what a shock. And then we just sort of coast along like we've been doing, and then flipping the script is talking, sort of going in our mind, sort of adjusting to it in our mind and sort of normalizing it for us in our thinking. One code of conduct for all. Focus on spirit, mind, and crucify the flesh. Focus on spirit and the mind and crucify the flesh. Don't let the flesh get a hold of you, the thoughts of the flesh. Crucify it. Pull it up by the roots. Don't let it get started. Don't let those plants get started. The weeds will start growing severely. We don't want that at all. Okay, those are the basics. The opportunity we have. The I am presence is here. The I am presence. This is a dress rehearsal we're doing now. Hopefully the I am presence will be here. We gave some examples in this video. I am presence. We choose to pay attention to that. Okay? We will evaporate our resistance to freedom. We will evaporate our resistance. We will give up body, flesh, world thoughts. Body, flesh, world, universe thoughts. We will give those up. We will give up body, world, body, flesh, world identification. We'll say, I'm not a body, I'm free. I'm still spirit exactly as God created me. No identification with body, flesh, world. We will take refuge in spiritual practice. We will take refuge in that. And we will say, ah, yes, I am total, complete failure. I abide in total, complete failure. I take refuge in total, complete failure. This is this negation type of assertion, the highest type of spiritual practice. We will evaporate our continuity fear. We absolutely will evaporate gradually our continuity fear. We will relax our minds, release our thoughts, and let them go. We will relax our minds, release our thoughts, and let them go, which is what we're doing here. We will release our self-concepts, especially the ones about success. We will release our self-concepts. I am this, I am that, I am this, I am that. No, I am complete failure. I'm complete total failure. And this is how we release them. I am complete total failure, period. Release all self-concepts. Release it. We will accept that we cannot prove that arrogance isn't arrogance. It's impossible. It's impossible. We will accept this, that there's no possibility of success in ever doing this. Okay. I'm not sure which slide. Let's see. Is this the no-nos? Yeah, all the basic no-nos, right? In the refugee, when you claim refugee status, okay. Well, water is allowed, but no food or drink when you're really practicing like this. Just water. Don't bring flowers or decorations. Don't try to decorate. Don't bring flowers. Okay, this is very serious. No music, singing, dancing, prancing. This is not a pagan festival, okay? So we're not celebrating the world. We're not celebrating the universe. We're not celebrating the wretched dream of death. So do not draw attention to your body. Do not draw attention to our bodies in any way, okay? No electronics, or have them on off. Turn your electronics off. Some people feel they wouldn't exist without their smartphone, so okay, well, just turn it on off, okay? Do not be under the influence of alcohol, drugs, or stimulants. Duh, you know, this is the basics, of course. No talking or socializing. This is not a socializing situation. This is not a hookup situation. You're focused on your refugee status, and you really want to solidify that refugee status, okay? Severe modesty of dress, appearance, and deportment. Okay, severe modesty of dress, appearance, and deportment. You know, when in doubt, you know, beige, monotone, without patterns, and, you know, subdued, do away with the ornamentation and the hairdos and the dressing this up and all the subdued. Don't draw any appearance to the body. The flesh, the world, the universe. We're not here to celebrate that. We're here to solidify our refugee status. Don't take pictures, audio, or video. I find that it distracts. It's very distracting. Okay. Maybe there'll be an opportunity to do that. Okay. We'll set aside an opportunity for that. But when you're working on solidifying your refugee status, this is very serious business, the most serious business. You need to give your full attention to this. You're not worrying about, is my battery running out? You know, how much is audio recording? You know, I got to get the right picture here. Oh, someone walked in front of me. Forget that. It's like golf. I try to take video playing golf and take pictures and video. I can't play golf. And when I left the camera at home, I did way, way better. Way better. No, you can't. Don't try to split your attention here. Don't try to split attention. Okay, so what to do? So what do we do when we're working to solidify our refugee status? Sit quietly, calmly, be still. Sit quietly, calmly, be still. Give up the intention to move about. Don't fight moving about. Just give up that intention. I have no intention to move about. I've given it up. Give up the intention to do anything. Give up your intention to do anything. I'm not a doer right now. I'm simply accepting, taking refuge. I'm solidifying my refugee status, but I'm not trying to think about being busy doing something. Give up the intention to do anything. Keep your hands to your hands, hands to hands, meaning, don't be touching this, touching that. Just hands are touching hands, basically, okay? Give up restlessness, scratching, coughing, etc. All these distractions can creep into us. Give it up. If you feel like I need to itch, don't scratch it. Hands to hands. Don't scratch it. Try to suppress your coughing, which you can do. Absolutely, if you really feel it's life and death, you can suppress your coughing and restlessness. Give up grooming behavior, okay? Give up grooming behavior while we're focused on solidifying our refugee status. Give up grooming behavior. All sorts of grooming behavior people engage in, right? Smoothing their clothing, smoothing their hair, adjusting this, adjusting that. That's all grooming behavior. Drawing attention to the body, saying, how do I look? How do I look? How do I look? Forget it. We're trying to solidify our refugee status. We are. Stay in neutral mode as if coasting in a car. This is the full stop in the wow. Okay, you'll feel the wow. When the I am presence, you'll feel the wow and you just say, okay, let me just I'm just coasting. I'm just coasting. Just coasting here. This is when you full stop in the wowness, okay? Be vigilant in your mind. Do not let it stray. Do not let the mind stray. Okay, try to stay in neutral mode, coasting mode in your mind. Keep sitting and engaging with the intensity. So remain sitting. And it's just, don't give up. Just keep sitting and keep allowing this engagement with the intensity that's there to just take place. Just allow that to keep going. Give up questioning. Give up questioning, right? The questioning part of your mind is actually an attempt to sow confusion within you. When people ask questions, the response is in words, right? And words are always ambiguous to some extent. And then they can ask more questions, and more. And before you know it, you've lost your certainty. You're all confused. And then they say, you see, you weren't so certain. You didn't have the answer in the first place, did you? This is a basic trick of the ego. When the ego is confronted with clarity, what it does is try to ask questions. And gradually, by doing that, it gradually pulls the whole situation into confusion. Then the ego say, why am I asking questions to you? You don't have the answer. You're confused the same as I am. We're all equally confused, you see? See, this is one of the major tricks. And so give up this questioning. I'm not here to question. Give up dialoguing. I'm not here to dialogue. Dialogue is the same thing. You feel yourself being pulled down more and more and more into confusion when you engage in dialoguing. You think you're getting clarity, but no, it's so many words and you're struggling with all these concepts. We're not here to do that. We're just abiding. So I am a total, complete failure, period. And I'm abiding in that. That's it. Stay in the flow of the moment. Stay in the flow of the moment. Don't be thinking of the future or the past. Just stay right in the now, right in the flow of the now moment. Give up goofing off, okay? Just don't goof off. That covers a lot of behavior, doesn't it? And you can tell when you're starting to get goofy. Restrain yourself from that. Restrain yourself from that. Restrain yourself from that. All right. Very great. And we're going to go back once more to Ramana, who was the most wonderful I Am Presence. We have photographs of him, example of I Am Presence. Just imagine that you're sitting there with Ramana Maharshi, with the I Am Presence, actually. And you want to goof off? No. Give up goofing off. Give up goofing off. Give it up. Give up that intention. I'm not going to goof off. I'm going to remain on my very best behavior, my very, very best, because I am solidifying my refugee status. Thank you, Jesus, for that. Thank you, Jesus, for that. All right. Very great. Let us get ready to wrap this video up then. That was quite a journey through a lot of wonderful graphics. And we are preparing for the opportunity to solidify our refugee status. We are preparing for that. We are preparing for that. So I'm continuing to do work to try to, give guidelines to help everybody out. Help everybody out. So at least we have some guidelines. Say, okay, what do I need to do? Okay, I know what I need to do. This is my opportunity. What do I need to do? These are the things that no-nos. Let's not do any of that. And then how to minimize the backlash and all that. And it's pretty simple. It's pretty simple, right? But we will work at it. We will work at it. We're working to totally solidify our refugee status. We accept Biden's total failure. I am total failure. I accept total, complete failure. Total, complete failure. From the standpoint of the ego, that's what how the ego will see me. I say, yeah, I accept it. I accept total, complete failure. What you're going to do about it, ego? Nothing. You can't do anything about it, can you? I accept it. I accept total, complete failure. And what is left? I am presence is what is left. That's okay. All right, so we are absolutely going along at tremendous... We've gone big today. We've gone really, really big. Which is what we need to do. We need to do this, and we are doing it. So congratulations to everyone. And we will solidify our refugee status. We absolutely have the tools to do so. It's just a matter of getting used to it. And this is about all my nerves can handle. I'm in a state of semi-shock, actually. This is so big that it's just... It's about all my nerves can take. So, get your rest. Eat some food now. Get your rest. Relax. Take it easy. Just coast in neutral. Guard against any body thoughts. Don't let them take root whatsoever. And they will try. They will try. Oh, let me think about this person. Let me think about that. Let me, you know. No, 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 no. Pull them up immediately. Don't let those weeds take root. Have to be very vigilant on this. The worldly thoughts will try to come back on you, no question about it. But we just keep on engaging with this practice every day, right? And solidify our refugee status. Let us solidify our refugee status. Let us solidify our refugee status. I am total, complete failure. Yes, I am total, complete failure. That's it.